Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's first news for Thursday, September 12th. It's made possible by the Vet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. We have some thick fog that we've been dealing with this morning. That'll move out later. Sunshine will return, and it'll be another dry day today. But our chief meteorologist, Dan Zarrow, says it will be a bit more humid. Now, we are going to stay rain-free through the weekend and probably into the middle of next week. Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. A search is underway in a Middlesex County town for a man who keeps showing up at a local apartment complex naked. South Brunswick police say the incident started in the middle of the night when a man donning a ski mask would approach residents and touch himself, but the most recent one happened in broad daylight Tuesday in front of a woman who was walking her dog. There's been a half dozen reports at the Royal Oaks and East Garden apartment homes on Route 1, but police believe there have been more and that it has been going on for months. If you know anything about it, police are asking that you would call them. We have photos of the man, well, of his face anyway, at nj1015.com this morning. Two New Jersey women are allegedly among the victims of a Bucks County man now charged with luring women to his home and spiking their drinks. Local authorities say 40-year-old Andrew Gallo met victims on the dating site SugarDaddyMeat.com, boasting of the great drinks he made. The drinks, police say, were laced with meth, ecstasy, shrooms, and THC. Multiple women have come forward to say they were drugged, then raped, including a 24 and 29-year-old from New Jersey. The youngest victim was 17. Even in critical elections, there are a lot of you that don't vote. Would you be more inclined to do so if you could put money on the outcome? A court hearing today could ultimately decide if you could place legal wagers on the outcomes of elections in the U.S., and online gambling sites are eager to take that bet. Betting on elections has long been illegal in the U.S., but in Europe it's common. Bookmakers are listing Kamala Harris as a slight favorite to win in November. Parts of a wildfire that started in Berkeley Township this week may continue to smolder this morning. Crews do have the blaze fully contained. The Ocean County prosecutor says the fire was accidental, caused by somebody not properly extinguishing a campfire. About 189 acres were burned. John Bon Jovi and a video production assistant are getting credit for talking a woman off a pedestrian bridge. It happened in Nashville Tuesday on the Siegenthaler Pedestrian Bridge. Bon Jovi was filming a music video. The bridge remained open to the public. Video of the encounter showed the assistant talking to the woman. Bon Jovi approaches slowly, waves to her, joins the conversation. Eventually, the woman turned around to face the two. They helped her over the railing to safety. Bon Jovi hugged her before she was taken away. Authorities say a Haledon police officer shot himself during a training exercise on a gun range. Passaic County prosecutor says on Tuesday afternoon at the county range in Patterson, the Haledon officer shot himself in the leg. He was rushed to a local hospital with injuries not considered life-threatening. Haledon's mayor sent well wishes on social media, saying it was a borough police firearms instructor that was involved in the accident. An iconic New Jersey company wants to change their name. Campbell Soup Company announcing at their annual meeting of investors they want to drop the soup from their name and just be known as the Campbell Company. The CEO said in a statement, the subtle yet important change will retain the company's iconic name, but better reflecting the full breadth of its portfolio. The company was founded in the Garden State in 1869, but they own notable non-soup products like Goldfish crackers, Rao's, Prego sauces. Trolls are about to take over Burlington County. Big Rusty, the huge troll sculpture, made of recycled materials, is getting 18 new friends all across the county. Commissioner Allison Eckel tells us the plan is to have all of those trolls in place by September 28th, and then Troll Trek begins later this month, featuring creatures made of recycled and natural materials. A couple of the new trolls will debut September 28th at the county's Arts After Dark Festival. Where you can find the new trolls on Troll Tech, you can find that at nj1015.com this morning. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Thursday, September 12th. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a great day.